Products in this video were provided to the author to do a review. All opinions are 100% authors and authors alone.
Hey guys, this is your friend Iggy back again. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to use the Logitech Brio 4K Pro webcam. I'm going to go ahead and compare it, compare it with the webcam on the Dell XPS 13 inch, then also compare it with the actual camera that you're looking at this video on, not only the video but the audio quality as well. So you're going to see me turning on and off audio and all that other stuff between all the cameras. So first off, let me go ahead. I'm doing also screen recording, that way you guys can check it out from there. Okay, so if I come over here and type in camera, you can see the really odd placement of the camera. It's right down here. Let me zoom in so you guys can see it. So you see right here, what an odd placement. Most cameras, it would be, or most laptops would be right up here. Again, just a weird thing. And so I'm gonna go ahead and record it. Whoops, I'm gonna record it. This way you guys can hear what this sounds like. So I would have turned that guy off. You're only hearing it from the laptop itself. I don't know how good or bad it is, but anyway, I'll go ahead and stop it. And I'll go ahead and include that picture. I'll do another one. All right, so you guys got that. So just go ahead, turn that off real quick. Now I'm gonna go ahead, plug this guy in. And I'll put the privacy screen back on there. Show you how it works too. And I'll go ahead and plug it in using the USB type C connection. Nice, and it clips right back in to place. I'll just open this guy up. All right, that way you guys can see not all webcams are the same. So now I'm gonna go ahead, and by the way, it is thundering and lightning out there, so you're gonna hear a lot of booming and bashing. So the lights may go off, but that's okay. This is a laptop, so anyway, go back into camera. All right, so we're still on this guy. So right over here in Windows, you'll see that little change camera. I'll go ahead, it's a touchscreen, so. All right, so instantly you guys can see that quality, the video quality change from this to that. Not only because, well, there, you see me there. Now it's brighter, but there's not a lot of detail. And then of course, then you go there, it is darker, but there is a lot more detail. And now on this guy, the only way that you can move that camera, you know, is to move the screen like that or like that. And it just, it's kind of awkward. Now on this guy, you can just go like this. Or like that. So a lot better. Okay, so then if I want to record, now this way you can actually hear me talking, and you can hear,
there we go, you can hear the quality difference. So I would have already turned this guy off, so now you can hear just how good it sounded from here. Compared to how it sounds on here.
Going back to the other one.
You should be able to really hear how the dual microphone sounds. And actually, does it help or hurt? Maybe me coming from this side. Can you hear me on this side? Does it sound any different? Now coming over here, I'm on the wall, so I really can't do any more. So This is on the left side of the camera, even though you see me on the right side. You know what I mean. On your speakers, can you tell a difference? All right, so that's pretty cool. Then the privacy filter, boom. So you can only see me on this camera, but it works perfectly well. The privacy thing there, unfortunately, is not going to block audio. The microphones are right here. And well, again, it's dual mic. Just turning that off, and then let's see what a picture looks like. So taking a regular picture from that camera. All right, I don't know how it looks like. I'll see it as I'm doing the video editing, but I assume it's gonna look good. All right, so jumping out of here, because I have to turn that off so that you guys can see these settings now. Now, this is all software that I had to get off of Logitech's website, so I'll go ahead and post it in the description below. But here we have on the home screen, this is the Logitech camera settings. Okay. Now we're under standard, but we can go under widescreen. What are you calling me, fat? I am. Anyway, so we can switch on and off HDR. It's already off. We can turn it on here. Or, sorry, it was already on, I turned it off. Okay, then if you're using PAL, you can switch it over here, or NTSC, you're over here. And then field of view, whoa. All right, so that's pretty cool. And then aside from field of view over here, you can get a little closer. I got nose hairs. But then aside from that, you know, that's pretty cool. And the camera's not moving. It's just, it's so zoomed in, it has so much more field that it, and then, you know, it looks like the camera's moving. We go under advanced, then here, remember how I was saying it was too dark? I can brighten it up. Can you see me? Or just put it back. And then I can play with the contrast right over here. Autofocus. Oh, it's on auto now. I can do that manually here. I've had too much. I drank too much. And I don't know. So you might want to. It's not a professional camera for taking photos, so maybe auto is good. But if you're going to be moving around a lot, you probably want to just turn that off and leave that under manual. Okay, then the color intensity. Whoa. All right, and I'll just leave that right at 50. And then auto white balance. Oh. Turn off auto. It's not horrible there. All right. And then it's hard to know exactly where everything is, so we can just restore defaults. Did it do it? Yeah. Restore defaults, and it puts everything right back to where it was before. I don't think it, well, here it has its own restore defaults, so you could always change it. So now, one thing don't get freaked out on if you open up the camera and it's only showing, if you have two cameras, it's only showing the other camera. And if you click over here, you get an error, close other app. That's because, well, you have this guy open. You can't use two apps. So close over here. And now you can use the camera settings here. And mind you, you don't have to use this software. You can use the Skype or whatever other Discord or whatever other software to for your camera. Just thought, I love this little guy. Anyway, sorry about that. All right, so enough with that. So then over here, they have, I also downloaded and installed Logitech Capture. Okay, and I'll install later. And here you can select what source. We're going to select the Logitech Brio. Okay, and then from here, we can also have, maybe not all of the settings. All right, looks like we do have all of the settings. Ooh, and chroma key. That's pretty cool. Okay, I need to play with that a little bit, but I literally just installed the software and I was exploring it with you guys, learning it. Then from here, I can take pictures or record. Looks taking a timed 3 second time picture, or I can record here. So it is pretty cool, all the software they give you, source 2, but this is, so the lights flicker a little bit, right? So this is a 4K camera. So just wanted to show you guys how easy it was. As I'm exploring it with you guys, you are going to see a lot more from me soon. I'm going to learn a lot more of this camera and show you guys more soon. All right, guys, Iggy again showing you guys the Logitech Brio 4K Pro webcam. More coming soon. Iggy out. See you guys.
Products in this video were provided to the author to do a review. All opinions are 100% authors and authors alone.